And Jesus, before he had communion, the Last Supper, he told his disciples, you have to go and prepare a place. Prepare for that meal. And it's time now to prepare ourselves. And the preparations that I have to share with you this morning will come from the book of Luke, chapter 22. And I will take it from verse 15 onward. Then Jesus told the disciples, I strongly want to share this supper with you. The supper is not only about us, remembering the body and the blood of Jesus Christ, but here Jesus is telling his own disciples, I strongly want to share that supper with you. How often do we invite Jesus to come and have communion with us? So in preparation of the supper, when you are praying, tell Jesus, come and have it with me. I invite you. I'm not selfish. I don't want to eat it myself. I don't want to drink the wine myself. I want you to take part in that party. Then after that, he took the cup, he blessed it, and he told the disciple, take this and divide it among yourselves. Bless the cup, take it and divide it among yourselves. Then he said, bring the bread. He took it. He blessed it. He broke it in pieces. And he said, this is my body, which is given to you. I'm giving my body to you. And you have been hearing this from time to time. But the important point for me is this. When you go to verse 20, believe me or not, some Bibles don't have that verse. But when you go to verse 20, he says, after the supper, he took another cup. And this cup is the most important cup. He blessed it. Then he said, this cup is a new testament in my blood, which is shed for you. This is not the first cup that he blessed and said, divide among you. The second one is now the new testament in my blood. This is a cup that we are talking about here now. And whenever you are praying, before taking your communion, first thing, invite Jesus Christ. Say, I don't want to take it myself. Please come. Secondly, yes, I've seen the cup, but between the two cups, the one I want to take is the one which is a New Testament of your blood. The one that will remind me you shed your blood for me. And after that small scenario, it was like a call from Jesus. Hey, one of you is going to betray me. You know, after eating the meal, he brought up the story. One among you is going to betray me. Meaning that after taking your supper, your communion, you need to have time of discussion with your Jesus. Tell Jesus, I don't want to be the one who will betray you. Mm-hmm. After having communion, I don't want to be the one who will turn, go behind your back and stab you in your back. Lord, please protect me. After the communion, disciples now started to say, okay, Jesus, who is maybe the greatest among us? And he told them, the greatest should be the younger one. Lord, teach me how to be the younger one among others. Oh God, who is the chief? Oh, the chief must be the one who is serving others. After taking a communion every time, tell Jesus, help me to be not the chief, but the servant of others. For that reason, I tell people every time, after taking a communion, pray. Tell Jesus, I've taken it. Help me to not betray you. Help me to be not the chief, but the servant. Help me to not be the greatest, but the younger. Because this is what you recommend. Then he warned them. In verse 31, I think, he says to Simon, 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 now the devil is coming. And he wants to destroy you like wheat. Tell Jesus after communion, I know the devil is after me. Please don't let him destroy me. And thank you because in verse 32 he said, I've been praying for you. I've been praying for you. And what he says in that verse, so that your faith will not fail. After taking your communion, tell Jesus, pray for me. I don't want my faith to fail. And for that, I can be able also to take the gospel to other brothers and sisters. Normally, this is a prayer that you should do after taking your bread and wine. Tell Jesus those few things. I need this to happen in my life. Unlikely, men will take the bread and wine. It's like, oh, Jesus, thank you for your bread. Thank you for your blood. And I thank you because you died for me. In Jesus' name, amen. That's good. It's not bad. But tell him more. He warned us about protection, betrayal, and all of those things. So remind Jesus, every time after my communion, I have to talk to you personally to require what you have written in Luke 22. We are going to pray for the bread and the wine. And while you are praying, pray for yourself. Tell God, prepare me to be ready to take it. Let us pray. Lord Jesus, we thank you so much for giving your blood, for giving also your body for us. And you say, do this for remembering me. We are doing it today because we are remembering you. Lord, bless our souls, our heart, our spirit. Prepare them in order to take this holy communion. We are asking you, Jesus, to purify us, and forgive us once again. Any heart, any mouth, any body which will use this wine and bread, let it be blessed by you, Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. I will ask you to help me. Come and help me. Thank you. Now we are going to go through another step.